It's the mental vomit show. What you thinking? Let it flow. You are now tuned in. RickyRick is in.
You're now listening to the one and only Mental Vomit Show. Mental Vomit Show. It's time to let your mind vomit with your host, RickyRick.
Welcome back to another Mental Vomit Show vlog. In these vlogs, I'm going to start doing a section called Broken Oath Sacrifice. And first of all, I want to start off with a moment of silence for Earl Simmons, a.k.a. DMX.
Let us pray.
Fuck what you heard.
Prayers are going out to you and your family. Now, I did a lot of research. I actually conjuncted a lot of footage to show you the people, just to put your mind, to let your mind vomit and think and have a perception on what happened. Yes, Mr. Earl Simmons, aka DMX, you know, had definitely a troubled past. He admitted himself he was addicted to drugs, though he was tricked into it from his ex-manager when he gave in that tearful interview he did in the Tower Leak interview. But is it something more sinister that actually took his life? Was it just a regular drug overdose? Well, for example, on the day that he passed, 4/3/21, and all the numbers and the symbolism doesn't lie. For example, like, you know, everything's pre-predicted. There's people talking about 4/3/21. That's actually a track he did with LL and Cannabis on that track, 4/3/21. But I mean, we're not gonna go down that path, just cherry picking little things because we can. But everything is through the symbols. Everything is hidden in plain sight. Even though he just wasn't just hiding things in plain sight, he was very, very upfront. Like when you see in DMX interview on Breakfast Club, even though people say he was obviously high and sweating and everything, he was spitting 1001 jewels, not like all these fake, phony, like deceiving, false perception celebrities that go on there and they have their managers have them pretty much have everything pre-written and they don't come off the top, they don't come from the heart. So that's why I salute DMX. When I always watch his interviews, he's always raw, rough, and he just doesn't give a fuck. He was actually supposed to play his part just like all these other celebrities and entertainers when they come up. He got the talent from God. He's definitely God's child, as we all are. And he didn't want to play that path, you know. So, and he actually had so much hurt and pain coming out from inside of him, and he would just show it inside his music. And a lot of big things actually are unfolding as we speak from his death. He passed on Good Friday. And that symbolizes the day of the Lord. And we could, you know, talk about the resurrection and everything else like that. So on Good Friday, that's like such a crazy coincidence. But once again, coincidences are usually not coincidences. They're actually just a label of symbolism that's unfolding. And while I was stating on the last video where we were talking about Lil Nas X, remember the satanic twerking sellout satanic shell celebrity that came out with the devil sneakers? It's crazy how they actually stated, because we truly don't know the day that he died, but when they actually stated the day that he actually passed away, it was actually on Lil Nas X's birthday. You know, and you could do the research yourself. I'm actually going to post something on there with the statistical facts. So he passed away on Lil Nas' birthday. Out of all birthdays, he passed away on Lil Nas X birthday. So it goes back, does a 360 into the satanic symbolism that they want you to portray, and they want you to go back and really absorb it inside your cranium. And now I know the radio stations haven't been blasting his songs. Now they're blasting some of his music because he passed away, and all these fake celebrities showing love for him dying, and some are showing real. I mean, you know, I personally didn't know him, but you know, the music that they're playing the music that he used to, you know, the industry music. They don't really play like the true, when he was going through his trials and tribulations music, like Lord Give Me a Sign, like Father's Heaven, like Amen, Angels, you know, they're not showing that. And even the Daily News, they're not even showing, you know, that he was actually much more than a rapper. He was an activist, and he actually pretty much exposed the industry, and that's why he's been sacrificed. And through these videos, you're gonna see how he talks, how the industry was jerking him, how pretty much you have to sell your soul to become where you're at, and how he will not bend over literally for these deceiving, conniving record execs. And you know, everything is there. Yeah, he did the blood ritual, as you see in his second album, where he was covered in blood and everything else like that. But they were trying to mold him into that path. They actually stated that they didn't even want him to pray, do his prayers, you know, prayer skits on the album. They wanted to take that off. They just want them to be rough and rugged. That's all they wanted, rough and rugged. But DMX, you know, once again, his character, his persona, and he was just straight up stand up soldier from YO, School Street, home of the brave. He didn't go out like that. Every album he has prayers. And once again, the radio stations that are playing his music for the little bit time that they are, because they're gonna move on to something else, like Cardi B twerking or dumb mumble rap. That's what they're trying to push. They're trying to push the agenda to pretty much fuck the youth and push a satanic agenda. They is deeper than what it is. Now, you know, just even the way when they're trying to do like the Cat Williams scenario, like have the police fuck with them left and right.
Normal traffic stop. Normal traffic stop. 18 cops, 5 cars.
Shit. This ain't no normal traffic stop.
He would actually talk about that when he was talking about when he was in Devil's Country.
Thank you for doing this, by the way.
Thank you for, you know, giving me the opportunity to be heard, you know, in a positive light.
Yeah.
Or just in a fair light.
And if I inadvertently talk about your situation, mm-hmm.
I got you.
You let me know.
I got you. Okay. I first came to Arizona, man, and I remember one day coming from the studio at 6 o'clock in the morning and pulling over on the highway. We like 4 cars, you know, just to watch the sunrise. And it was at that point that I fell in love with Arizona. I said, you know what, this has to be God's country. You know, because I'd never seen anything as beautiful as that sunrise. Then I met the devil in God's country. You know, and it's not so much who. It's what, you know, what happens and the things that the devil does. It's not so much a person, even though he acts through people. You know, you can't call one person the devil.
Joe Arpaio?
You know, you can't call any one person the devil. You can't do that because no one person has enough power to be the devil. You know? And, you know, it's through all these hardships that I realized that, you know what? This is God's country because I met the devil here. Because if I hadn't met the devil here, I wouldn't realize I was strong enough to overcome the obstacles that the devil would place in my path. And it's by overcoming these obstacles that I realized that this is God's country. Because he helped me get over these obstacles. He helped me get over these hurdles.
Okay, so but when you're done here, when you're out of here.
I'm not looking back.
You're not coming back?
No, I'm not coming back. I'm not coming back for a show. I'm not coming back for a visit. I'm not even driving through the states. If I'm in a plane and they're gonna fly over it, I'm gonna go around, okay?
But you love this place.
I love the scenery. I love the scenery about it, and I love the freedom that it initially gave a person. Remember I said, when I first came here, the last exit on the 101 was Pima and Princess. Yeah, that was the last exit, you know? And, we had fun. We had the four-wheelers, you know. We just rode the trails. Pretty much the same thing I did when I bought a house out here, but until, you know, things, yeah, I don't know.
Do you, when you think back on this whole thing,
yeah,
what went wrong in Arizona? How did you end up getting in so much trouble here? Was there too much temptation here, or
I actually didn't get in any trouble. I was never arrested at the scene of any crime, the police came and arrested me for something. You know, it was always, let's get an arrest warrant for this guy, you know?
Last is a probation matter involving possession of marijuana, which is also a class 6 felony.
See the bad treatment going on. Only one in here. The only one who got arrested today. Do it every time, man. Every time they do it to me. They gotta be quiet about it. I get my rights violated, but I gotta be quiet about it. Let's go.
Come on, let's go.
Now, let's go. It's a f***ing bitch.
And everything else like that. You're gonna see in these videos how, just out of his voice, he would actually show you all the sequences on how, at the very end, he's been sacrificed. So let's check this out together. Once again, RIP Earl Simmons, DMX, me, The Mental Vomit Show, everybody YO, everybody in the world loves you, and you're in the 50s club. Once again, it's the symbolism. The 50s club. I know they have the Kurt Cobain, I think 27 club, and all these other celebrities. They do have a 50s club. Like, for example, like Michael Jackson, Bernie Mac. You can go down the list. It's all about the symbolism. And we know Prince Harry. Prince Philip. Prince Philip passed on the same day too. And the racist Fox, F-A-U-X media, actually came out with that subliminal racism cover, which I edited after I seen it. So you gotta check that out. And no, he was more of the prince, you know what I'm saying, of the world with the power of prayer. And Prince Philip, not even statistically, factually, he's burning in hell anyway. That's something else. So, but he was a lizard pedophile demon. But that's once again going down a rabbit hole on another episode, which I definitely will be talking about the royal family and how through some of the research that could come out, you know, was affiliated with Epstein and everything else. But I don't want to talk about that on this video because, you know, the YouTube robot lizard elites will take it down. So right now we're talking about DMX, RIP, and let's see how and why DMX broke the oath.
The industry, man, it's not the same. Doesn't have to do with talent, it's about playing the game. The industry, real niggas is dying to get in. The industry, just to find they don't fit in. The industry ain't what it used to be. The industry's trying to control the way you MC. They want you to dress like this and talk like that. But I'm going dress like this and talk with the bat. The The industry got your word meaning nothing. The industry, fuck what you heard, because he's bluffing. The industry, money, bitches, hate. But I dare you to try to take a fucking thing off my plate. The industry like, wait. But in the streets, we like, get him. 17 up in that thing. Catch him sleeping and hit him. The industry, if you ain't got a strong mind, the industry will break you down. It's a matter of time. The industry, vultures with nothing to feast on. See me? I'm getting my beast on. The industry, stay in the dirt, play in the dirt. Test the wrong one in the industry and you will get hurt. I'm not an industry artist. I'm an artist in the industry. So I do what the fuck I want because nobody can finish me. The industry, wanted, dead or alive, new artists to sell their souls in the way they survive. The industry don't give a fuck about you, but the industry couldn't make a dime without you. The industry, I'm sick of this industry shit. The industry playing them like a industry bitch. They tried to finish me quick, but I am long, so I stand strong. Fuck a beat. Listen to the words in the damn song. I only know how to speak the truth, you know what I'm saying? So I got a little short joint I'm gonna hit you with, you know what I'm saying? And it basically reflects on my relationship with the industry. This is what it is. Often, my words fall on deaf ears. Motherfuckers be listening, but don't hear. Talking to a nigga, he be sitting right here. I be like, where you going? Nigga be like, yeah. Thank you.
Get up and try again. I mean, today that's all we can do. We make the moves that break the rules. A fool and his money are soon parted, so we take from fools. If and when you ever fall down, get back up. Drop some, stop fronting, pick that shit back up. Stand for something or fall for everything. Wait for the right pitch or miss with every swing. In the absence of the truth, bullshit prevails. So what they did, fucked around and threw truth in jail. The objective is to keep you blind. So along with the handcuffs on your arms, they got shackles on your mind. Seek and you shall find, accepting failure is the only crime. Fall down 8 times, get up 9, nigga.
The dog!
I told you. So like every song, I look at it like, okay, this is a single. You know what I'm saying? When I write it, I got a picture, the video, and everything, you know? Mm-hmm. So I don't be trying to make no album fillers, you know? Something just put on the beat and just blah, blah, blah.
I've been rapping for 20 years.
I've been rapping for 20 years, you know what I'm saying? I don't know at what point I officially became in the industry, and you know? Record label wants to make a successful artist, you know what I'm saying? And they can do it, you know what I'm saying? They buy radio time. They buy time on fucking BT and MTV, you know what I'm saying? I mean, it has nothing to do with talent at all. It's, you know what I'm saying? This is, they create fucking stars. Fucking stars. I pay for every aspect of getting my album, taking my album from my mind to the stores. I pay for it all. I pay for the studio time. I pay for the living expenses, you know what I'm saying? I pay for the packaging, you know what I'm saying? The pressing of the records, the promotion. I pay for all that shit. And they own the masters. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? I'm paying for it, but they own it. The fuck, I'd have to be a fucking idiot to continue to operate under these conditions. It's like, I'm not, and then the highest paid artists get like 26 cents off a dollar.
Yeah, that's sad.
They sell your shit for $20. You know what I mean? It's like, come on, dog. Yeah. You can do a little better than that. Yeah. I can't use my own music without getting your permission.
Exactly.
And I paid for it. Not only I wrote it, you know what I'm saying? I paid the nigga for the beat. I paid you for loaning me the money, you know what I'm saying? I paid you back your money, now we splitting because you loaned me the money.
Yep.
But you own my shit. I don't owe you a motherfucking thing. Why is you holding on to my shit?
Yep.
And that's standard. Like, man, get the fuck out of here, man. Suck my fucking dick. You know what I mean? Fuck that. Fuck man. That. Should be having me heated like a motherfucker, man. You know what I'm saying?
And while I think about it,
I'd be like, nigga, it's a straight fucking rock. You know what these cocksucking motherfuckers had the nerve to fucking offer me? The fucking the video game they did. You know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. First one did good, so now they're coming out with a part two. They sell a game for $50. These niggas come to me like, yo, guess what, X? We're gonna do a part two. Now, mind you, they use my music throughout the whole fucking game, and I'm the hardest character to get to. You know what I'm saying? So it's pretty much like my shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They say they come to me and say, yo, we're gonna give you a $25,000 signing bonus, advance, and 2 cents off every game we sell.
They know what
$50
they're doing.
Fucking game. You giving me 2 cents? Let me think about that for a minute.
The most realest dog in the whole game. The guy who reinvented the game. The guy who put it on there, man. I mean, you came out at a time when it was all shiny suits.
Yeah.
It was all like sparkly shoes.
I gave Def Jam their best year ever.
Exactly.
And I'm the only artist to date with 2 platinum albums in 1 year.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Understand
and what
that.
Did they do? They sold the company. They invited me into a house and they sold it. Yeah, I am mad. You know what I mean? All right, I'm mad. I feel betrayed, man, but it. You know what I mean? It's a business and I'm gonna carry it like a business. But my music is still my fucking music. And you play on my music, you play on my life. You play on my life, nigga, you're gonna disappear. You know what I mean?
Yeah, things are definitely changing there, man.
Yeah, they got a whole new staff now, so I gotta go in and see what's up. You know what I'm saying?
Now, you got issues with the industry. What's going down with the industry, dog?
The industry is full of a bunch of dick-sucking, dick-riding, bending-over-the-desk-ass niggas, straight up like that. Whoever don't like it, bring it, nigga. Bring it. I don't give a fuck. Bring it. Bring it. Bitch. Bitch.
Yeah, keep moving. We just walked up. What's up, baby? Yeah. See, rap niggas can't do this, man. You mean walk to the hood? You know what I mean, man? My motherfucking self, man. And I'm good. I ain't spelled all that, baby. You know what I mean? Shit don't mean nothing, man. The niggas can't do this. Niggas can't walk down the block by their motherfucking self. Niggas, they pussy. You know? Niggas is pulling over when the police harass them. You know what I mean? Fuck that. We out here. What's up, baby? They don't give a fuck about none of this shit, man. They ain't gonna catch me. What up? That's what I'm good at. Niggas ask where I'm going for my
foot. They got this new breed of rapper that's paying DJs to play their shit.
Right.
And, you know what I'm saying? They sucking the record label executive dicks and it's like.
You know what I'm saying? They sucking the record label executive dicks and it's like.
There's too much of that going on.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Let me be me. Let me be the artist that I am and just play my motherfucking music. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Now they want you all up under this, you know, sitting going to dinner with them and shit like that. Going to dinner with them and shit like that. And, you know, all that favor for a favor shit. I don't get down like that. Look, I give you the music, you give my money. That's it. I'll go hard whether I'm right or wrong till I'm dead and gone. It's on. What y'all really want? Bring it on. I'ma let life be my song. Yeah! X, nigga, let's get it on. Man, are you for real? Hey. Looked like 15. You know what I mean? So we had to send.
R. Kelly, what's up?
We had to send a Def Jam rep. R. Kelly, what's up, brother? We got minors in the building.
R. Kelly, what's up, brother? We got minors in the building.
You fucking bitch ass nigga. When I see him, I'ma spit in your fucking face. Bang. Fuck you. R. Kelly.
R. Kelly.
Damn.
Fuck that nigga. Fuck that nigga with an elephant dick, you fucking bitch.
Wow. Rough Rider G Unit Radio.
Yes, this is what we do.
This is how we like it.
Kato, yo, you know what I'm saying? And me, yo. Yo, nigga invited me to the studio.
Wow.
Now, we show up at a video shoot for him. You know what I'm saying? Now, Kato was pressing me to do a song for a minute.
Wow.
Like, oh, I'm gonna do it. Leave him alone. Nigga, Kato kept the nigga safe in Chicago. That nigga's pussy.
Wow.
Like, so I show up in the studio on his behalf to do a song for him. So I tell nigga, now he wasn't even at the studio, but I'm still there because I'm a professional.
Shit.
So I said, all right, I'm gonna bang. Lee, what up? All right? I'm gonna bang my shit out, you know what I'm saying? So I say, yo, you know what? Let me take the beat, you know what I'm saying, back to the hotel and watch it. I'll come back home. So, and his manager's like 50 years old, his uncle and his manager.
Wow.
And I said, yo, ask him to the beat. This nigga is in a room, in the studio.
Nah.
You ain't got enough respect to come to the room I'm in. You mean? You mean
a he's in
room?
A separate room. He got two.
He's in a room downstairs.
Come on,
somebody
man.
To talk to you.
Sit
come on,
his
man.
Uncle, which is manager. I ain't got a problem with that. Come but on. The way he talked to the nigga was crazy. Like this. He talking through the fucking lock.
Yo. Nah.
You're right. Ask supposed to know if he can take the beat.
Come
nigga,
on,
right
man.
Right back to
the
lock.
No.
I said right there, like.
Oh,
that's what's up?
That's that wax shit.
I said, why I can't think of. Let me see you talking about. Because, you know, beats, it's a fucking beat.
That's wax.
It's a
yo.
Beat. You ain't your vocals in on there. Can't nobody put that on a mixtape. And hold up. Who the fuck you think I am anyway, nigga? Like,
wow.
I'm not thirsty to leak a fucking song with you.
Come on,
I don't
man.
Even fuck with you like that. Yo.
First, I want to say, you know, glad to see you in the situation. Not that the situation you were in was right. I'm just saying that.
Let's be frank about it. The situation I was in was terrible.
But it's definitely great.
The situation I was in was not
great,
good.
It's great to see an artist of your caliber and of your size to be someplace, man, like Sony.
Well, I appreciate it.
You know, yeah, definitely, man.
Where I'm understood. Where I respect it.
Yeah, correct.
Wait, is that the jealousy factor?
Yeah, I definitely.
I mean, it ain't my fault. I sold more records than you. Come on, son.
I am the fucking streets. I am the motherfucking streets.
Cops ain't nothing but people too. I'm done with niggas. What?
Okay, this is how we do it. You know what I'm saying?
Now I'm gonna do about $150 up out of here in a motherfucking Suburban 2500 with 23-inch rims on it. I whip my dick out and take a piss like this, but I don't got a piss.
I'm trying to form a union, you know what I'm saying? Because there's no one who protects the artists, the rights of the artists, and we continue to get jerked, you know what I'm saying? We pay for our fucking music, but the record company owns it. What type of backwards that shit is that? That's like getting a loan from the bank for a house. That's when you're paying back, they still own the house. That shit is not fair, you know what I'm saying? And the percentage that they give you isn't fair, you know what I'm saying? The split is ridiculous. The highest paid rap artist gets maybe 18 to 23 cents off a dollar. The fuck type of shit is that, man? I'm not a slave, man. And how the fuck you gonna call me a risk and get hold on to me for 7 years? If I'm a risk, it's 1 year at a time. 1 year at a time. That's what you do with a risk. You don't lock a risk in for 7 years, especially when the average expectancy of anybody's career is 3 fucking years. You'd have to be a super incredible nigga to outlive that contract and then get money for yourself. You know what I'm saying? Right. Shit is crazy.
Who you got supporting you with that? Anybody supporting you on that?
Yeah, I'm not gonna, you know, say any names, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, you know, I talked to a few people about it. Some niggas are scared. I mean, you know.
Nobody wanna step up, huh?
Yeah, but, I mean, it's gonna get done. Fuck, man. You know what I'm saying? Because I wrote that motherfucking line. You know what I'm saying? I put that beat with it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Come on, man. And it's being sold because of me. I mean, if I put some whack shit out there and they still made it sell, then that'd be a whole other story. Then they get that percentage. But they don't. They don't. You know what I mean?
Is there something you want to tell the people that help you support that, man? That they might know?
Well, I'm pretty
this is going straight to the hood right here for the younger
guys. Oh, to the hood.
This is the hood. DVD magazine.
Yo, keep it gravy, man. You know what I'm saying? To the fellas, you know what I'm saying? Be a man about your shit, you know what I'm saying? Don't be no coward ass nigga, you know what I'm saying? To the ladies, respect yourself, love yourself, you know what I'm saying? Appreciate who you are, but know who you are. God bless you all. It was all about, yo, motherfuckers were paying to get this shit played. The radio, the record label was in bed with the radio station, who was in bed with the fucking MTV and BET. It was like, all y'all motherfuckers is fucking each other. I don't get down like that, Loki.
You know what? Fuck them. The game is bullshit, man. The game is fucking bullshit. If you want to rap or sing or whatever, don't become a part of the game.
Don't become a part of the game.
And ain't nobody but you taking my life. Because I know not many do make it through the fight.
But there's still a many who walk with your grace, cause I know a plenty who walk with your face, in their minds and their hearts, with the word on their lips, but still stray from the herd. I'm sure you've heard how it gets, cause the word is a gift that'll break any yoke, stronghold, or bond down to a third of its strength. When you're free, the name of Jesus is free indeed. All you need is faith the size of a mustard seed. All things are possible through Christ who strengthens me. It's my destiny to be the best I can be, to give you the best.
Is there anything else you'd like to say to watching this tonight?
Pray for me, so I pray for you. Don't believe everything you hear. Don't believe everything you read. And only believe half of what you see. God bless you.
Don't forget to subscribe to the Mental Vomit Show podcast, where we let your mind vomit.